Hey guys, how's it going today? Beautiful day here today, probably in the mid-70s. A little bit of a breeze going on. Nice relief from a hot spell. We hit 103-104 last week. That was pretty rough. But today is absolutely beautiful. We've got a few good days of weather coming up. And so I think I'm going to go ahead and try to cut a couple of fields. I'm going to start on my place. I also cut one of my neighbor's fields. I'll start on my place. I'll probably cut 3, maybe 4 acres. I've never really measured it. I'll use my international Super MTA I've been working on this spring. I'll be using my Ranch-Rite 165. This is a 5-foot drum mower. Pretty sweet little unit. It's my one luxury haying piece of equipment. It's new and modern and just works. It's amazing to me that those itty bitty little knives do such a fantastic job. But you understand, you get out there at that large radius, those things are whipping around at a pretty nice high velocity, and it's always the tip of the knife that's cutting anyway. So you know, you could have a full length knife and it wouldn't cut any better, just wear down and then cut worse. The knives are cheap, but I'm going to grab my grease gun, put a little grease on those bad boys, and start cutting some hay. So stick around. All right, got grease on all the zerks, and this is a fact of life around here. I always have to pay attention. Those little buggers end up everywhere. So I imagine when I fire this thing up, we'll get a few of them buzzing up around us. They generally don't bother you too bad at this time of year. So they'll be a little mad, angry as a hornet, but I typically only get stung in the fall. I'll go ahead and get some spray and knock that one out anyway. That's just the joy of living out in the country, away from all the pesticides and herbicides of the suburbs and the city. first time I've ever cut it for hay. Generally, I just let the animals graze it off, but it got kind of ahead of me this year. I think it'll actually make some tonnage. Here on this end, this is where we were filming, it's pretty light, but and these are pretty short windrows, so it doesn't look like a whole lot of bulk out here. But you start getting out here, and there's some pretty good bulk out here. We'll get a few bales off of here, enough I think to make it worth the while. This other field though, that's another story. Realistically, I'm just cutting this to protect my horse's eyeballs. Probably 15 years ago, we had a pony that got some cheap grass in his eye, and despite our best efforts and a lot of vet bills, he lost that eye. He still had a pretty good life for quite a few years after that, but he was a pirate horse with one eye, and it was this foxtail kind of stuff that just got up in his eye. So, and that's when they were grazing. Haven't had any trouble with it in a bale of hay. They'll eat around it, but even then, I don't like to feed it to them. I've seen cows get it stuck in their cheek, and you'll get a big old nasty cyst in there, and I don't want that to happen to any of my animals, my cows and horses. I'm going to go ahead and cut it anyway, and we'll bale it up, and it might just get turned into compost or into a retaining wall. Get put back into the field somehow. This field needs a lot of remediation, needs a lot of love. It's my poorest ground on the place here on this upper end. The lower end is much better ground, but it's overtaken by some, I call it a red weed. It turns red when it matures. But you know what? We're just going to mow it all down, bale it up, put it someplace. So stick around. I'll just run roundy round in a few more circles. Watch if you want to. Well, I got the two fields mowed, the little one and the larger one, so we'll call it 1 acre and 2 acres. I know that's not what they are, but we'll call it that. So that 2 acre field, that's just so full of foxtail that hay's not going to be worth anything. I'll probably just compost it or give it away to somebody who's desperate. This other little field, it's the first time I've ever cut it for hay. Generally, I just let the animals graze it. And I think it'll get a little bit of hay up here, and it'll be decent quality. It'll be stuff that'll feed through the winter. It's every little bit helps. I'm not too worried about the quality of it. There's some nice clover, purple clover in there. And the grass isn't that bad, so it'll feed. Yeah, that other field, I don't know if it was worth the fuel to mow it down, but I got to get those foxtails out of there anyway. So I'll mow it down, bale it up, get it off of there, turn the animals onto that field for the rest of this year, just to have them keep it knocked down for me. And we'll go from there. So, all right, we'll let this cure for a couple days and we'll get out the Massey Harris with the rake and rake it up. I still have one more field to mow. Over my neighbor's property for some pretty good hay. Tractor's running okay. It's not great. It's missing a little bit at the lower RPMs. Probably a timing issue. Might need to check the valves. I've never done that, but it's the first time for everything. Voice is going a little bit. I don't get hay fever that bad, but it was pretty dusty out there. Yeah. But anyways, it was a good day. Beautiful evening. Sun's going down. Going down some trees on my junkyard of Jeeps and fun stuff. I'll talk to you guys later and I'll catch you on the other side.